So now joining us, Congressman Yarmuth. Welcome to the program, Congressman.
Thanks, Cenk. Great to be with you.
It's great to have you here. Yeah. So, first of all, what's Obama's economic team doing wrong, by your estimation?
Well, I think you have, with Tim Geithner and Larry Summers, and until a couple weeks ago, Christina Romer, you had people who come from a very, very limited perspective on the economy, and that's pretty much either an academic perspective, in the case of Christina Romer, or else Wall Street and the Fed, and the New York Fed, which is essentially Wall Street. There's nobody in that team who's ever hired anybody, who's ever worked real hard at a low wage job or a moderate wage job, and we need that kind of grassroots, ground level economic input to actually figure out a way to get the economy moving again. Because the problem is not that Wall Street doesn't make enough money. The problem is that the vast majority of American people, particularly American workers, have not had their salaries, their take home income raised over the last 10 years. They've had their purchasing power diminished. So that's the key to getting the economy moving. My brother's in the barbecue business, and he used to be a Republican, and because he didn't want to pay as much tax, and he called me back in 2008 and said, you know, I've decided that I'm going to support Democrats now, because I finally figured out that if nobody can afford barbecue, it doesn't matter what my tax rate is. That's the kind of perspective and attitude that I think we need in an economic team in the White House. And Tim Geithner, they're smart people, but again, their perspective is very limited.
You know, it's funny because you use that analogy to explain why you should, you know, go for Democrats, but this is theoretically a Democratic administration.
Exactly.
Did they have the wrong central assumption here, that if we just give all the money to the banks, that somehow it'll trickle down to the people? And did that fail? Was that assumption wrong?
I think that is clearly the message that they are sending, and clearly the message that my constituents, and I think a lot of people around the country, have gotten, that the government cares more about Wall Street than it does about the average American worker. And they may, you know, I think in an academic sense they understand that, but in a real world sense they really don't get the importance of working from the bottom up. And that's something that I think is absolutely critical.
So if you were the president, what would you do? Would you say, look, I need a new advisor? Who would it be? And would you fire Tim Geithner or Larry Summers? Because say, hey, look, you know, you said I should continue with the TARP program. You said if I give the money to the banks, we'll have more jobs. We don't have more jobs. TARP didn't work. Your plan didn't work, so you're fired. Should he do that?
I don't think it's necessary to fire them. Again, they're very smart people. What's necessary is to get a different perspective as part of that team. And, you know, what I would do, in my opinion, and I, you know, I'm certainly open to other suggestions, there's only one way to create jobs immediately, and that's to make a significant investment in infrastructure. And we're going to have to do it anyway. That's the way to put people to work immediately. All the other things that we're talking about, whether it's education, sure, we've got to invest in education. Whether it's creating new economies and new energy jobs, yes, but those are longer term propositions. They aren't going to happen in the next 6 months. What I said yesterday, and I think this is the key, we have an opportunity as a party, and the administration has an opportunity, to convince the American people that we know where we're going. That's where I don't think this economic team has been able to show us and can show us. We need to get somebody in there who can lay out a plan, a strategy that the American people believe in. And I think this team has lost credibility.
So, Congressman Yarmuth, let's get really specific then. If TARP isn't the answer and giving the money to the bankers isn't the answer, and what the Obama economic team has done so far is not necessarily the answer, what is the answer? How would you create those jobs? Is it massive new spending? Is it second stimulus? And if it is, how would you direct it specifically to create jobs?
So I wouldn't call it stimulus. I would call it investment in infrastructure. I think that's critical. The other thing that I've recommended, a number of members of Congress have, I had this conversation with Christina Romer about a month ago, was let's not give this $30 billion or $20 billion in lending capacity to the banks. Let's lend it directly to small businesses. Because what they have not done is eliminate the other obstacles to getting this money into the hands of the people who actually can put it to work. And they haven't removed the roadblocks, the regulations, the FDIC, which is preventing a lot of community banks from actually lending money. They're making it very hard. So if they're not going to do it, if the banking system can't handle it or won't handle it, let's make direct loans. We're doing it with student loans now, and I think we're entirely capable of doing that.
You know, I want to rip my hair out that we gave hundreds of billions of dollars to the banks, trillions indirectly, and now since they haven't lent a nickel, we got to go give the money directly to small business anyway. So it's like I feel like we're doing it again.
Well, we are doing it again. One last thing for you. Yeah.
But Congressman Yarmuth, one last thing for you. When you get down to the job level, though, and let's say they want to come in and get a loan and we find a way to get them that credit that they need, is there really still enough manufacturing jobs in America to be able to solve this unemployment problem? And if there isn't, then what do you do?
No, there aren't enough manufacturing jobs, and I really am. I should have mentioned it earlier, but we have this new agenda that we're working on in the House and pushing forward the Making It in America agenda, which changes some of the trade regulations and the tariffs so that we incentivize people to build and construct things in the United States rather than coming up with the ideas and then outsourcing it for the manufacturer. We have an agenda to do that. And I think we ought to move on it quickly. That's not going to create a lot of jobs in the next 6 months or the next year, however, and that's what the critical, to me, the critical window is. That's why I think we've got to get infrastructure started. Those jobs will be up and running right away, and we ought to make sure we can get money directly to small businesses so they can put it to work. I can't tell you how many small business people I've talked to who said, if I could get money, I'd open another store, I'd develop another piece of property, you name it. The potential is there.
All right, Congressman Yarmuth, thank you so much for joining us. Really.
Okay, Cenk, thanks for having me.
Always a pleasure. Now, still ahead here on the DR Show, California, the nation's canary in the coal mine.